Back now on Sunrise, the widow of Russian opposition leader Alexei Navalny claims her husband died after being poisoned with Novichok, nerve agent.
Live to Europe correspondent Ash Mullaney now. Ash, she's accused the Kremlin of hiding his body to cover up the crime.
She has. Good morning, Nat and Shervo. Alexei Navalny's family have been refused access to his body, and now the Russian authorities are saying they won't release his body for another 14 days while they carry out a chemical examination. All of this just fueling speculation that the former Russian opposition leader met with foul play while he was being kept in that remote prison. Yulia, Alexei's wife, has been a staunch supporter of his over the years. She is vowing to continue his fight. Accusing Putin not only of murdering her husband, but of now hiding his body too.
We know why exactly Putin killed Alexei 3 days ago. We will tell you about it soon. We will definitely find out who exactly and how exactly this crime was carried out. We will name names and show faces.
Now, his wife is also urging the EU to sanction Vladimir Putin. The US is weighing up more sanctions too. But we know from the war in Ukraine that that is a largely symbolic measure and it doesn't tend to prove to be much of a deterrence for Russia anyway.
Ash, he's still having an impact, isn't he, after his passing? Mm. Despite hundreds of arrests across Russia, people are still laying flowers in tribute.
Just the very act of buying a bunch of flowers, going to these memorials in Russia, is an act of defiance. And we know that defiance can be deadly in Russia. And we've still seen hundreds of people gathering there, more than 400 people that have now been detained by Russian authorities. So, yes, you're right, Shervo. Even in death, it's clear that Navalny is still a powerful figure in Russia, guys.
Thank you, Ash. That's why it's so brave of his wife to his widow to say she's going to carry on his work, isn't it?